Well, good morning. Today is November the 11th, and the day the citizens of the United States remember and thank the veterans of our nation's military for their service to our nation. I'm reminded today that freedom is not free, and that the liberties we too often take for granted were paid for by the ultimate sacrifice of many, the service of men and women who went to war that we might be free. Thank you. A shout out to my son-in-law for his service to our country, for my dad, who served in the time of the Korean War, and of course, all those that have gone on before us. Thank you so much for your service. Now, we continue our chronological devotional study today with our scripture reading from Luke chapter 23, John chapter 18 and 19, and our devotional titled, quote, "The enemy of my enemy is my friend." Now, today's Bible reading brings us to the third of the gospel accounts concerning those things Christ suffered for our sins, according to the scriptures, particularly the prophecies of Isaiah in chapter 53. Now, Pilate, having declared Jesus was innocent of political sedition, Luke 23 and verse 4, brought against him of the chief priests, Pilate sought an escape from the demands of his accusers, declaring, "I find no fault in him," Luke 23 and verse 4. The chief priests defied Pilate, saying, "He stirreth up the people, beginning from Galilee to this place." And when Pilate heard Jesus was a Galilean, he sent him to King Herod, a puppet ruler of Galilee appointed by Caesar, and a man who was the Roman governor's political nemesis. Though his hands were bloodied from beheading John the Baptist, Herod had longed for an opportunity to encounter Jesus and had hoped to witness one of his miracles, Luke 23, verse 8. Now, the king's eagerness quickly soured when Jesus refused to answer or even acknowledge his authority. Incensed by the snub and having heard the charges brought against Jesus by the chief priests and scribes, Herod and his men of war began to mock and deride the Lord. Now, an ancient adage, and it's the title of our devotional, does come to mind: "The enemy of my enemy is my friend." And we read in Luke 23 and verse 12, "And the same day Pilate and Herod, who had been enemies, were made friends together. For before they were at enmity between themselves." That's an interesting statement. Allow me to put it in context. Pilate and Herod had been enemies, but from this day forward, they became friends because they shared in the greatest travesty of justice in human history. They were forever guilty of the most egregious act, having condemned the holy, altogether sinless Son of God, Jesus Christ. Pilate, having declared in Luke 23, verse 4, "I find no fault in him," attempted to shirk his responsibility to exercise judicial integrity. Unfortunately, when he failed, he lacked the moral character and fortitude to do the right thing and release Jesus. We read in Luke 23 and verse 24 and 25, Pilate gave sentence that it should be as they, the priests and the scribes, required. And Pilate released unto them Barabbas, a man known for sedition and murder, whom they, the religious leaders, desired above Jesus Christ. And they delivered Jesus to their will, that is, to be crucified. You know, as much as we might be tempted to look upon Pilate with disdain and wonder about his sudden friendship with the likes of Herod, we should look into our own souls. The pressure to compromise with evil men and women is never too far from any of us. How often have you denied Jesus because you lack the courage and moral fortitude to do the right thing, even while others were choosing to do wrong? How easy it is to long for popularity and acceptance at the sacrifice of obeying God's word and walking in his truth. Tradition insinuates that Pilate died an insane, broken, miserable soul. His conscience was no more able to bear his guilt than his soul could escape God's judgment. I challenge you this morning as I close. Romans 12, verse 1 and 2 says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Don't compromise your convictions. Don't allow evil men to draw you away. Do right. God bless. Bye-bye.